I always pay my bills off immediately. I never wait to pay a bill. When I was 10 years old, my family, we failed to pay the water bill. The water was turned off, and I gotta tell you, having to walk down to a creek with a bucket of water, to get a bucket of water and back, just so you can flush the toilet, taught me that whatever you do, always pay your bills, pay them on time, and pay them as quickly as possible. That was one of the worst periods of my life. It only lasts for a short period, but it was a learning experience. When I was 4 years old, my mother moved my sister and I from Detroit, Michigan to Flint, Michigan to flee my abusive father. And it was a situation where we didn't have anything. In fact, we didn't have a place to live. And the situation was so bad that we had to live with another family. It was totally unstable. I didn't react very well to it at all. I struggled academically. In fact, I was very immature, and I really screwed up. I made the situation worse by actually failing first grade because I was so preoccupied with playing around. I just couldn't focus in school, and it's one of those situations where I failed my mother. I was so embarrassed that I failed because of what I did and what I didn't do, and the fact that my mother worked at the same elementary school in which I failed the first grade when I was 6 years old. So that was one of the worst times of my life. And in this video, I want to talk about the worst events in my life, the worst periods of my life, because I believe it's absolutely critical to look at where you've been so you can avoid making the same mistakes you made in the past and appreciate the good things that you have now. I'm Reginald, also known as Demcad. Welcome.
I like to remind myself that things can always get worse, and I'm actually better off than I often acknowledge. There were times in my life where things were much worse, and it's easy to take things for granted and not realize that, hey, you know, you've made progress in your life. So that's something that I like to highlight. It's something that you may want to consider doing as well. You know, first I'll start off with the five worst days of my life, five worst times of my life. Not really in any particular order, but there's a situation where my mother had a health scare. She actually had a stroke, and I received this email from my sister. She says it was entitled "Concerns," and she told me that my mother had a stroke and she was in the hospital, and they didn't know if she was going to make it. And I was in Alaska at the time. I had joined AmeriCorps, and I had to make a decision whether I should fly back, you know, because I didn't know if she was going to make it or not. And essentially, the situation was I could only fly back home one time. After that, it was it. So if I flew back and visited her at that point, and she passed away, or I flew back to Alaska and she passed away, then that would be my last flight back. I couldn't get back to the project I was working on. And that was sort of my limitation. And I was like really depressed. I went to this one place. I ended up in an alley somewhere in Ketchikan, Alaska. And for some weird reason, these black cats came out of nowhere. And one black cat just rubbed up against my leg or something. I don't know if it wanted food or anything, but I was feeling so depressed. And my spirits were lifted up by that situation. Ultimately, I decided to not go back to Flint, Michigan at that point. My mother pulled through, and I guess things worked out for me, but that was one of the worst times. Another really bad time was when I graduated from college. That's usually a good thing. It was a really bad time for me because I didn't feel like I could find a job that paid decently. But I was right. I really struggled in Flint, Michigan. I was unable to secure good employment for reasons that were my own fault and other reasons that are beyond my control. I felt really depressed and demoralized at getting that degree and realizing I couldn't find a job. Another really bad time was when I graduated from high school. It wasn't so bad, but I just felt like I wasn't prepared for college. And to be honest with you, I really wasn't prepared for college as far as English and the writing and a lot of other things. I was really far behind, even as far as reading. I was far behind. I really benefited from college. I was able to catch up. That was a really rough time for me, and I'm glad I did go to college. I did grow as a person. I learned a lot. I developed some critical thinking skills, and really beefed up my basic English skills. I mean, something I needed to do. And I learned a lot about myself. I made some mistakes there. I was socially awkward, socially incompetent, I would say. But anyway, eventually I I evolved as a person. So those are some of the worst times. Another time that was really bad was when my sister, she had a health issue, and you know, she almost died. I mean, she almost died on several occasions. She actually passed out at one point in public. There's some situations where at night, there's a really bad situation. I was living with my mother and sister, and she had a health issue, and I had to take on a lot of responsibility in making sure she was okay. There were times where, you know, a couple times where we had to call the ambulance, and it was a bit rough. It was definitely a bit rough. It was scary. You know, whenever you have family members, it's always going to be very challenging for you. So those are four times that are really among the worst times of my life. I had my own little health scare. Well, actually, I was paranoid that I had HIV. Okay, so I hooked up with this girl, and anyway, I got paranoid because I did not use a condom, and it was stupid of me not to use a condom. But anyway, this was when I was in college. It was, you know, I was really worried about it, so I went to get this HIV test at the university. And like, you know that movie Final Destination? I saw the first one. It was around that time, and like, I had to wait like a week for the results or something. This is long before those instant tests and all that stuff. I was in a movie theater, right? And I was watching Final Destination. It was a movie about about these kids who escaped death, whatever. Some guy had a premonition that the airplane was gonna go blow up or something or go down, and he freaked out at the airport, and he convinced, well, because of his freak out, several other high school kids follow him off the plane. They decided not to get on the plane, then the plane went down and blew up or whatever, and so death was essentially stalking them. Death was trying to claim their lives one by one. But anyway, I was in a theater, and one of his characters was making this speech about how, you know, every little decision we make, you know, could affect whether we live or die, and what career we go into, the people we sleep with. And as soon as he said like the people we sleep with, I was in the theater like like I was so I totally freaked out in the theater, like, oh snap, you know. And like anyway, the day of the results, the nurse wasn't really in. I think that nurse wasn't in. As some other female and employee at the university, I think the nurse was trying to, she was a nurse practitioner or something, I forgot. She was trying to convince me that, you know, I had nothing to be really freaking paranoid about or anything. I just, you know, and so I was freaking out. I was really getting on them about, hey, I need the results, you know, like a crazy person. Eventually, she got the results, and she showed me, see, negative. I'm like, oh, you know, but like the paranoia. Anyway, I guess those were so like the worst times of my life. I guess I'll try to figure out what the best times were, you know. So there you go. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.